So I did a video a couple of months ago where I went on a rant explaining the difference between power raking, scarifying, dethatching. And I did that video because when I was a new homeowner getting into lawn care, it was kind of confusing what people said each of these things actually did. And when I looked at a lot of YouTube videos, for the most part, it was just confusing and it didn't make sense to me what people said the difference was. So I made a video explaining my point of view on it, and I got a lot of responses to that video. So today I'm actually gonna address one of the most common responses I got. And I'm not gonna go in depth about the difference between these two attachments in this video. If you wanna watch that, I'll put a link to it. And if you have no clue what the hell I'm talking about, you probably haven't seen that video. So I would go watch that first, then you'll know what I'm talking about. Hey everyone, my name is Sam and I'm an average Joe lawn nut. So if you're a new homeowner getting into lawn care, or if you're just a lawn nut like me and you want to learn how to get the best and healthiest lawn using simple tools, simple strategies, because like most of you, I have a normal job. I don't have all the time in the world for lawn care. So I try to use simple strategies, just normal tools available to everyone. And that way it makes lawn care kind of more fun to me and hopefully more fun to you as well. So subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on the future videos. And it also does really help support me. All right, so a lot of people commented on that video. I got a lot of emails, a lot of comments in the comment section, people reaching out to me on Instagram, friends, neighbors, and most responses were actually quite positive. People agreed with me, but there were some that didn't agree with me as well. And there were also a lot of people calling me an idiot and other not so flattering words, but thankfully YouTube automatically deleted those comments before I even got to them. But they had a lot of inappropriate words. And I don't really care about those. I mean, I don't mind people saying they don't agree with me and kindly giving me their arguments why. And a lot of people did that, which is perfectly fine. I always welcome different opinions, as long as you do it like they did, like grown-ups do. But anyway, so today I'm gonna respond to one of the more common responses I got. And one of the more common responses I got was, why would the manufacturer call it a dethatcher if it isn't? That was by far what my neighbors and other people seeing the video and the comments, emails were about. People thinking that, well, if the manufacturer says it's a dethatcher, then it's a dethatcher. So why would the manufacturer call this a dethatcher if it doesn't remove thatch according to me? And I would say most of these manufacturers, they have a lineup of kind of lawn care tools. And one of these machines, like the Sunjo or the Greenworks dethatcher, they kind of have to have that in their lineup because they need to compete with each other. So if one has it, then the other ones also will make one. And I mean, why wouldn't they? Their number one priority is to sell equipment. And to be perfectly honest, I think you and me watching this video or have 100% dedicated themselves and becoming a lawn nerd, I truly believe we know more about lawn care than they do. They know their machines, they know how to sell them, but I think we actually know more about lawn care than they do. And I mean, I imagine most of the manufacturers releasing one of these machines actually believe that the top layer of dead grass and stuff, the debris on your lawn, is actually thatch. And I mean, if you think that, then yes, this will 100% take away thatch. But according to me, that is not thatch. And I've actually seen a lot of videos claiming the same thing. And I've also seen certain manufacturers make videos where they claim the top layer on the lawn is actually thatch. And for those who actually think this will remove thatch, then I would ask them, why even bother have a second attachment? What's the point of this one? If you remove thatch with this, then why two attachments? Then there's no need. You can just settle with this. And manufacturers actually get this wrong in their manuals as well. One of my viewers pointed out that the Sunjo manual actually confused him. And sure enough, I read the manual and some of the things kind of confused me as well. And they kind of contradict themselves in the manual, saying one thing in one area and then another thing that goes against what they just said. Like this section, for example. They say that the fine needles will scratch the surface of the lawn and pick up light debris. So they say that it will pick up light debris, and light debris to me is not thatch. And they also say when used as a scarifier, so the other attachment, it will remove any unwanted parts from the lawn, and unwanted parts to me, that's thatch. So in this section, I would agree with them. Sure enough, this will take away light debris and the scarifier will take away unwanted parts of the lawn, which is thatch. And in this picture, they actually say that this is a scarifying cylinder and the other one is a raking cylinder. So I mean, so far so good, I agree with them. But then they move on to this table. And in this table, you see that they're explaining the different settings. So if you put it in a high setting at a 10 millimeter depth, then you can use the raking attachment. They even call it a raking attachment. And now it says it will remove thin thatch layers. And then they say if you go minus 10 millimeters, then you can use the scarifying attachments for scarifying. So then I would ask, then what did you mean by light debris and unwanted parts of the lawn? Which is it? I mean, is unwanted parts of the lawn thatch or is the light debris thatch? It doesn't really make sense to me. So if I wanted to learn more about thatch and what these things actually do, and I would read this manual, afterwards I would be kind of confused. And then they actually move on saying that this will aerate your lawn and the other attachment will take away thatch. So again, just adding to the confusion. So thatch for me isn't light debris on the lawn. Thatch for me is actually below the surface. You can't reach the thatch with these. I showed that in my last video. I actually pulled a plug and showed you. If you want to use these spring tines, you can't go that deep with these. And I showed that in my video last time. If you try to go below the surface with these and remove the thatch, you wouldn't be able to. You would need something solid like this to be able to actually get in there. You would need to go below the surface and actually remove it with these. And I actually did a video shortly after that one explaining my view on what thatch really is. So go watch that video and see if you agree with me. And if you don't agree with me, please go ahead and say it, but maybe not call me names. Just say you don't agree. That's enough. So I think in the end, whether I'm right or wrong comes down to what you think thatch is or is not. So if you think that thatch is the light debris on the lawn, dead grass clippings and such, then 100% this will dethatch your lawn. It will rake it off and you're good to go. But then again, I would be interested to know then what is your opinion, what this thing does. Does this also remove thatch? Does this remove more thatch? Is it to aerate your lawn? So again, I think it comes down to what you think thatch really is. And to me, it's not the light debris on your lawn. So again, I would never say this will dethatch your lawn. This is just a power rake, period. So this was the most common response I got to that video, and I just wanted to give my opinion on it. Just as in that video and every video I make, you don't have to agree with me. But I mean, I think I'm right, of course, otherwise I wouldn't make a video about it. And so far I haven't heard any arguments that will convince me otherwise. I actually have a lot more responses, and I think the second most common response has a lot more merit to it, but I'll cover that in another video. So subscribe to the channel if you haven't, so you don't miss that video. And we'll see if the next video will be from inside the house, because it's getting really cold right now. It's about in the mid-20s, so about 2-3 minus Celsius, and as you can see from the lawn, it's pretty much dormant now. It's not growing, nothing more is happening. I still have a few more things to do out here, like winterizing the sprinklers, but other than that, I think I'm pretty much done out here. It's getting really cold. I have my winter jacket on, I have gloves. I only have a few more videos left, then I'll move them inside the house if it's too cold out. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.